Hi, this is Debbie Boyer, and in this video segment, we're going to talk about uploading video to Google Drive and then sharing it out through Google Classroom. When we're looking at the current version I have open of Google Drive, you're going to see that we have a Chromebook login.mov file, and you can see that it's a video because it has the little red icon right in front of the file name. If we look down the screen a little bit further, you can see that there's a Google URL shortener .mov file, and the same thing, it has the little red icon in front of it. Now, one of the things I like is that Google has a new version, a newer version of Google Drive, and you can go back and forth between them at any time. If you like the older version, that's great. If you want to go to the new version, that's great, and go back and forth. But you go to the new version by looking at the cogwheel within Google Drive on the top right-hand side of the screen. So I have Google Drive open, and I'm going to go to Google Drive settings, and we're going to experience the new drive. It automatically changes over, and you can see it's just a little bit cleaner version of Google and Google Drive, and it has some different wording. So instead of share with me, it has incoming, and instead of create, it has new. But one of the things that I like about the new Google Drive is when we're working with videos, if we scroll down the screen, instead of having the red icon in front of the videos, it actually has a little video clip or thumbnail that lets us see that the video is fully uploaded and fully processed. And that's important when sharing videos out through Google Classroom. Let's go down just a little bit further, and we're going to see that Google URL Shortener has a video thumbnail, and it is fully uploaded and fully processed. So when we get ready to upload a new video, we're going to go to New instead of Create like the old version, and we're going to click on File Upload. And one of the things that is important is we created these videos using using Smart Notebook software. And when you save that file, it saves it as a WMV. Now, a WMV file plays great on computers, but they don't play well on the Chromebooks, or they don't play at all on the iPads. I have opened a WMV file on the Chromebook, but it is not a supported file. And so we were going to try and stick with MOV files or a different file that would upload, such as an MP4. Both are supported for Chromebooks and iPads. But I've chosen to convert a file to MOV. If you need to know how to convert a file, it's super easy to do. And I would suggest using Format Factory. It's a free program that lets you easily convert files, and there's actually a video out that I've created walking you through how to convert a file using Format Factory. Super easy. Go find the video and try your hand at converting. When we're going to upload now, we're going to choose the Google Clearly extension, and it's a MOV file, and I'm going to go ahead and click on that file and choose to upload it. And you can see that it's uploading. I see the window down in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. The shorter the file, the quicker that it will upload. The longer the file, the more you might have to wait. But it doesn't take long. This one was a minute and 51 second video, I believe. So it's completely uploaded, and I'm going to go ahead and close the upload window out. But one thing that's very important to notice is that even though the file is uploaded, I can see it right here, it is not fully processed, because if it were fully processed, it would move to a thumbnail instead of that red icon in front of Google Clearly extension. So I do not want to share this out with students until it is completely processed. So we're going to look back at that in just a minute and see when it's ready to be shared. For right now, I'm going to go out to Google Classroom. And if I want to share that out, if all I want to do is upload that file, that's great. But if I want to share it out, I'm going to go to Google Classroom. And I can share out videos through announcements or even through assignments. But I'm just going to choose announcement right now. And I'm going to say, please watch this video and comment. Something along that line. Now, I have various choices of choosing to share out video. One is the clip here for an attachment. One is to go directly to Google Drive. One is a YouTube link, and we'll talk about that in a different video, and just a regular link, which we'll talk about later as well. We're going to go ahead, since we upload that video to Drive, we're going to go ahead and choose Drive. And you can tell that it's on Drive now and not upload from the computer. You can see that at the top of the screen. And I'm going to scroll down just a little bit, and I want you to notice that the Google URL shortener is ready to go. The Google Clearly extension video has not yet processed, and I can tell that because it still has that red icon. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the Google URL shortener, and all I did was click on it, and it is ready to post. So when I get ready to put that out to my students, I can choose which periods of the classes I want to include in that video announcement, and then all I'm going to do is click on post. And it's going to be available immediately for my students. And when they have a video that is in the right format, MOV, and it has fully processed, then when the students click on it, it'll open up and be able to play by clicking on the play button. Sometimes if you try to attach a video that is not fully processed, the students will get a message that says, whoops, this video can't be viewed. And that's because it hasn't finished processing. There'll be something along that line with the message. And you'll know that when you look back at Google Drive or wherever you've tried to upload the file, it's not fully processed. So keep that in mind when you're sharing out with students. We're going to come back and look at My Drive. And now you can see that the Google Clearly extension has fully processed and is ready to be shared. And I could go through the same process with my students in Google Drive and attach that video for them to watch. When you get ready to go back to the older version of Google Drive, if that's your preference, you can go back through the cog setting wheel, and you're going to leave the new Drive, and you'll be right back at the version that you've been working with. And we're going to look down here again, and you're going to see that these are fully processed, but you don't know that because you're not getting the thumbnail view like you are in the new Google Drive. So I hope this helps. Videos are an awesome way to share out content and build background knowledge. And so I hope you'll consider creating your own videos and using them with your students. Thanks a bunch.